head missing on his back. That's all we want. He doesn't look too bad at all. Yeah. He's gone over in that hollow. I haven't seen him for a little bit. Just constantly moving, eh? Once that one with the patch on his back, with the ear missing, yeah. Once he puts his head in the grass, or stationary, once he's stationary, he'll take a shot. Just constantly moving, though. Whatever we need to do is go along the side of that creek. See that bush to the left-hand side? That's what. If we get behind that, that should get us a closer shot. They're all sort of moving that way anyway. Plus the rapids will mask our noise. Yeah, that's what we need to do. Yeah, that's a go. We need to stick that way anyway, because of the wind. Those rapids will mask our noise anyway, so in that long grass, so we should be good.
There's probably about 15 pigs here, and we're off them for literally like half an hour. They're about 33 yards, between 33 and 37, and I wasn't confident in making a perfect shot because they're moving around, and yeah, so I thought if we come around here along the creek here and use this as a cover and hopefully try and get an angling shot in through here, and it worked out perfect. He was 20, just a little bit over 20. Put a good shot in, and I'm pretty sure he's only on 100 yards through there, so we'll go check him out. But there's more pigs up here, so I'm gonna leave this arrow.
Well, it seems to have been forever since I've sort of had a chance to have a hunt for myself on this place. But Jerry's had a successful few days here and knocked over an old chittle stag, and I've come across, you know, a fair few pigs, and he knocked over a boar as well. So I've got a day or so before some more hunters come in. They'll be targeting the rooster and chittle, and I'll get them to get stuck into these hogs along the river that are doing a fair bit of damage here at the moment. But yeah, I might slip in there and try and knock over a boar or two before they get here, and hopefully find a, you know, half decent chittle, or we might even see one of these rooster stags that seem to be eluding us. So fingers crossed, and really looking forward to the next couple of days.
Thank you. bit of a slow start this morning. A bit indecisive actually, because I wasn't sure where I should be going. Sort of torn between going upriver, across the river, in the middle, or down the river where we're at now. We kept an eye on a rooster stag out in the flats, in the fog, but he's inapproachable out there until he decides to bed up with whatever horns he decides to for the day. So we came down the river, boated across, came up here, and that's actually the same mob of pigs that Jerry shot a boar out of a couple of days ago. There was like the biggest ginger boar there. We seen him the other day too, and Jerry nearly got a couple of cracks at him, but just found him feeding here. I just couldn't quite close the gap and get the right angle I wanted. And he changed positions, finally changed positions, and I had a sow that was feeding close in a holler, and she moved off as well. And then we just cut around a little bit and got a shot across that bit of a holler there. He's just over the horizon. Yeah, straight through the shoulders, and I don't think he's going far, just down the bank and straight down. So if they've been into her here. The hogs have been devastating this riverbank. It's probably the most hog sign I've seen here in I don't know how many years I've been hunting, but it's just full on at the moment. Well, it's a pretty long shot for me on this hog here, but had this grass sort of covering his chest or rot where I needed to be, and it was just around that 25 yard mark, and he's back down here in this hollow here, just here, and where I really wanted to put the arrow. I couldn't see, but I knew just from that curve, if I passed through the top of that grass, it was gonna sail into his vitals, you know. And yeah, just that real good sound you can't beat when an arrow hits a ball through the shoulders like that. And yeah, good result. I just made my way to the high bank, tried to intercept a pretty decent mob of pigs, cutting up the bank. Yeah, need to thin out a few on this block, and they just walked out too far. And couldn't make a move on them. The wind was a bit iffy as well, but not to worry. We'll keep mosing on up here, and we might even bump into them. back on the high bank up here in a few hundred yards, hopefully, so. Traced our steps off the, followed where all those other pigs have walked down here, and seen a boar feeding down the gully, so I just slipped in pretty quick, got into 20, I didn't want to muck around because this wind's pretty iffy. Angle shot, low on the short ribs at the back there, and should have punched out his opposite side shoulder. He come bolting back past and just died down here in the creek, or the river, so yeah, very happy. Yeah, he didn't get the benefit of the doubt, I just, yeah. He's just starting to get a pad and get that shape of Benny. Didn't want to stuff around too long because of that wind and never really give me a chance to see what he had up front, but not to worry, I said we need to put a few on the ground here because there's a number of them, and yeah, more than happy with that.